Lemon Dogs' loss to SK Telecom. He didn't have the best game there, but especially in this matchup, these guys respect each other's Zed play. Nuke Duck plays a fantastic Zed over in Europe, and Reginald has an incredibly impressive record on Zed as well.
Full respect bands coming out here. Corki taken away from Wild Turtle has been very strong. Vi taken off from the odd one as well. This time around, Kennen being taken away from ZoroZero. Actually, I believe they banned that last time around as well against ZoroZero.
Yeah, they actually... Yeah, they must have banned it. Mm. And it's been picked away from him as well a couple of times. ZoroZero seems to actually be someone who's most comfortable on Shen and Kennen. And then his Zac, at one point, he had the Sorcerer's Shoes instead of Mercury Treads in a heavy CC game and could not get into teamfights. I know the analyst desk had a lot to say about that one. He hadn't adapted to the 3.11 patch, and I think that was more inexperience from Lemon Dogs coming in, just kind of taking things for granted and not really realizing how far they'd come.
And Thresh was the final ban from TSM, which does mean that Elise has been picked up by Dexter. Now, Dexter's had some fantastic games on Elise in the past. Absolutely destroyed Gambit Gaming, who've just qualified for the quarterfinals single-handedly from the jungle with Elise.
Yeah, and I talked to N-Rated about them first picking Elise because they do it so often. And they just think it's because Dexter is so absolutely comfortable on it that his comfort on that jungle is more important than other roles. For instance, Ahri is still available. Nuke Duck could have played Ahri. They could have taken it away from Reginald. Now it's up for TSM. In Lemon Dogs is one of their games against OMG in the group stage. They let OMG take ZoroZero's Kennen away just so they could pick that Elise. That's how much they care about that pick.
TSM have been left pondering, it seems.
Sona
with 10 seconds. Sona is going to be in there. That's going to be for, of course, X-Special. Tyrus, the last man to make that selection. It's going to be Ezreal, actually,
really?
For Wild Turtle. That's going to leave Ahri open.
So, coming into the World Championships, I was expecting the two Trinity Force AD carries to see a lot of play in Corki and Ezreal, because those are traditionally the AD carries that we saw build Trinity Force. Didn't expect the Trinity Force Kog'Maw to make such an impact, but still, this is Wild Turtle, I think, living and dying by the Triforce. Picking it early. I'm very surprised that we didn't see an earlier Ahri pick, but I guess the teams are just ramping down on that hype train.
So this is interesting. If Nuke Duck does go for that Diana, which has now been switched to Garen.
If he goes for the Garen, though, then all hell's breaking loose.
Oh.
That makes
sense. I think this is Nuke Duck saying, look, I want to respect Reggie for this time around. I don't want to get counterpicked like I have been in the past.
I really wonder, though, because Reginald, when he plays Ahri, I don't think he cares what he plays it into. But Krepo was also talking about how the European game had changed a lot around mid lane, where oftentimes the last pick would be the mid lane. And it just depends on a giant game of chicken at this point. Does TSM want to have Reginald's pick saved until the very end, or do they want to lock down the rest of their team comp?
Well, it is potentially going to be Ahri Renekton in that top lane, along with Zyra. Could be seeing Ashe come along with that Zyra, by the way. That's a potential change around from Lemon Dogs. Is Reggie going to go for this Ahri and the Jarvan, of course, for the odd one?
It would make the most sense, but they're definitely taking their time with this one. Yeah, because the odd one, having no access here to Elise, which has been previously his favorite jungler, and obviously having the Vi banned away, which was so successful for TSM the last time they were victorious over Lemon Dogs, does make a lot of sense for them.
There is the Fizz. So, trying to go for that counter, it's what worked so well for Peke earlier on. 17-1-3 on Fizz. That was destructive.
Well, to be fair, Peke got like 17-1-3 on whatever he was playing.
He has played very well this tournament. That's one man that stepped up. Caitlyn is the choice for Tabs. I don't know how I didn't even count that one in. It was the champion that, honestly, from the very start of the European Super Summer Split back in DreamHack, we were saying, can he play any other AD carry? Because all he seemed to play was Tabs. He banned out Caitlyn against him and seemed to struggle. So, interestingly, he did leave that one to last. But the final pick for Dyrus is Rumble.
All right, it's kind of just comfort right now for both of these guys, because TSM has the Rumble-Ahri combination with a little bit more lockdown this time for Dyrus's equalizers. That was one of the issues earlier when he played Rumble, is there was nothing to keep the enemy team inside of it. Now they have the Cataclysm, maybe comboed up with X-Special's Crescendo. And then we look across at Lemon Dogs. It's the strong laning of Tabs and Mythy looking to completely shove out Wild Turtle and X-Special in that lane. Strong laning up top for ZoroZero, and hopefully that is enough setup so that Nuke Duck's Fizz can go fishing.
So the champions are locked in, so let's check out what you guys at home, you are winning this tournament. You need to make sure you can keep winning it. Let's take a look at the fan votes for this one. According to LollySports.com, you've gone with the Americans. It's TSM, 67% voted. Let's see if that works out for them.
Well, Crepo has stuck true with his European pride here, and he has also picked the Lemon Dogs. He has to find some way back here. And honestly, I think this is a very close matchup. Both of these teams, despite how well TSM beat Lemon Dogs coming in, are in very similar situations. And if we look at the actual seeding, TSM was the number two seed, so was Lemon Dogs. Not really sure if the European or the North American LCS is stronger yet.
Well, we will see, because they're about to get underway. Remember, TSM won game one. Let's see what they can do in game two. I spoke to Lemon Dogs just before this game. They are taking this absolutely seriously. Of course, OMG and SK Telecom T1 have number already one. Qualified through in this group. So this is all about pride on the line. North America versus Europe.
Absolutely. And North America-Europe is a very deep-seated rivalry.
Yes.
In League of Legends. We can say that for sure. I know all throughout the LCS season there was constant banter about whether North America or Europe was better. I got to say, first split, Europe definitely had the edge on them, fan perception-wise. Then the All-Star game happened. North America took a little step back. Then we had Cloud9 going 30-3 in the regular season. But now, Fnatic and Gambit have both moved on with two teams into the quarterfinals here of the World Championships, where North America just has one. Still means these guys got to fight it out for pride.
It'd be sweet irony if Cloud9 does draw one of those European teams as well. So, Lemon Dogs as the blue team, TSM as the red team. They are 1-0 up in this matchup. Let's see if they can make it two as they go for this red buff invade going around. Going to get them ward placements in there. Will they stick around? So far, in the pretty much the group stages, we haven't seen too much crazy aggression. Generally only to come out from maybe OMG. Lemon Dogs, of course, themselves did set something up against OMG.
Yep.
But against TSM this time around, they are being very passive.
Yeah, Lemon Dogs had the very clever play in their very first game and then kind of ran out of ammunition for it. Now they're just running away. There's not very much that can actually do stuff here at level one. If Mythi landed a Grasping Roots and Lemon Dogs was actually down for a fight, they could maybe engage. But walking into a danger-zoned Rumble Flamespitter is a lot of damage to be walking into in any type of level one fight. So I think Lemon Dogs is smart to just keep their distance from TSM right now.
Nothing crazy coming out from the opening starts. We do see Reggie with that Thorn's Ring and Nukeduk gone for the Crystalline Flask. So they're just going to be chugging on down. I guess we're going to see a fairly passive Nukeduk on Fizz to start with. Tends to be traditional, especially against Ahri, that long-range champion in the mid lane, up against the melee. So Nukeduk's going to be looking to stay his distance on the tower, I think, at the start of this lane.
And something that Nukeduk has done well on Assassins all throughout the regular season, not so much at the World Championship because of the quality of mid laners in this group, and he's struggled a little bit, but it's keeping his farm up against almost any mid laner, even when he's playing an Assassin. I really want to track how well Nukeduk can farm against Reginald, knowing Reginald is generally surprisingly aggressive to most players and should be looking to completely shut down Nukeduk in mid.
And it is an interesting balance between these two teams, because you've got TSM here, third World Championships in a row, not going to go out of the group stage, but it doesn't matter. They've got that wealth of experience behind them. Mm-hmm. Now, bear in mind, Dyrus was with Epic back then. The Odd One was around, Reggie was around, Wild Turtle is obviously the new member in there, and X-Special was in there, so they've got a wealth of experience. Up against Lemon Dogs, they only got into the LCS back in the summer split. You know, they changed in there from Sinners Never Sleep, yep, qualifying through against All Authority, and then came in saying, we're going to get number one in this league. Sure enough, they did, and now here they are on the big stage, and it seems that a lot of these teams, we heard Monty talking about it, you know, the experience on the big stage. Some mm-hmm. teams just can't quite take it early on because you don't understand the pressure that is on them on this big stage with the crowd staring at them.
Yeah, and for a while it seemed like TSM lived for that big stage, but especially if we are to believe their scrim claims, where every time we talk to them it's like, yeah, we're winning 90% of our scrims. I was talking with Darius backstage. He said they went 5-0 against Fnatic in scrims as well. So I'm not saying it's true, but if those are true, then playing on the big stage is actually a huge problem for TSM if they were that good of a scrim team.
Yeah, maybe that is. Seems that way. I know Fnatic were having good results against Lemon Dogs coming to this one. So it seems that the pressure is on both of these teams right now because it's all a battle for Europe. Odd One trying to set something up here this time against Nukeduk. He playful tricksters away. Doesn't look like he's going to get too close. Nukeduk's pretty much sitting on that tower as I expect.
Yeah, that lane is in a perfect place for Nukeduk right now. He's been last hitting very well at turret as well. He's actually going to jump ahead of Reginald and farm once that wave hits the turret. So Reggie's definitely not doing much to shut down Nukeduck here. Missed that last one. They're dead even at 23.
Speaking of farm, that top lane where we see the odd one trundling off to is actually in favor of ZoroZero so far. 28-19 with that wave pushing in, but this time he's very deep. He's going to have that slice and dice, but he's going to make sure he gets it across the minion because he is far too deep. Dyrus is trying to set this up.
It is so hard to gain connection with slice and dice. If they could get ZoroZero to at least partway engage, he gets the slice, has dice and flash if he wants to try and jump away.
Yeah, he's going to use that flash just to dodge out the old one. Hasn't got that cataclysm. Remember, he's only up to level 4, and the Dexter is going to come around the side there. The old one continuing to give chase. Now they're going to turn it around, and here comes Nukeduck. Is the bait going to be deep enough? They're split targeted, though. They're going to come in around. Reginald's now the focus target. Nukeduck's going to go on towards him. Dyrus taken very, very low by Dexter at the top there. He may get dropped down. First blood's going to come in. Dexter will take it. And would you believe it, Lemondog's turn around a gank attempt to a victory.
And that fight was really decided by the mid lane. Nukeduck had actually managed to shove Reginald back a little bit and then beat Reginald to his own jungle while having a level advantage. That's the reason that Dexter and ZoroZero could turn back around onto Dyrus in the odd one and turn around that kill. And it's really unfortunate for Dyrus, who's now given up first blood in his last 4 games.
Oh, very deep stuff from Nukeduck there. It's going to take the ignites ticking on him, but he will get away from that one. Took too many tower hits, and Reginald will come out on top of that one. A very even lane in that mid. The top lane massively in favor of ZoroZero after that kill on Dyrus. And of course, the bottom lane, well, that's slowly being clawed out by Tams as well.
Yeah, this is across the board right now going well for Lemondogs. The top and bottom lane were given slight edges based on the action that happened in TSM's red buff of the jungle. But then it's just a Caitlyn Zyra lane. Tabs lives for a 2v2 lane with Caitlyn. That's exactly what he wants. And he's just doing all he can to push back Wild Turtle and X Special.
The differing of items between the two mid laners, Nukeduck and Reginald. Nukeduck gets himself double Doran's Ring. We'll see how that works out for him because it's a Fiendish Codex for Reginald. So he's going to be rushing that Deathfire Grasp out as soon as possible, whereas Nukeduck can have a little bit more sustain. But look at this, Dexter going top.
Round 2 right here, and the odd one is even farther away. Odd one's even walking through a ward. They know the flash is down. If he lands a blind stun, Dyrus could be in a bit of trouble.
He's going to land that cocoon. He's got the slice, gets the dice on him. Dyrus is going to go in towards the tower. ZoroZero happy to tank this one up. Now he's going to switch the aggro across to Dexter. But you can see the damage. The focus is there. Odd one coming in past that tri ward. They realize they got to back out.
ZoroZero wasn't quite level 6 on Renekton right there, so he could not pop his Dominus, and they did not have enough sustained damage to take down Dyrus. Dyrus with an extremely defensive build already coming out, really knowing he's had a bit of problems dying in the last few games, and at this point he's just looking to survive.
And that helped that ZoroZero had that farm early on. He went back and got Giant's Belt very early on, so we do see the fact that the pressure was laid on that top is going to lead to Dexter going for an invade here, but he's going to have the odd one coming around in a moment as we have a pause. So that looks like it's Mithy that's caused the pause. He's talking to the referee. You can see him on the backdrop. And looking, it seems like it's actually...
One.
It looks like it's a light on Tabs' face, judging by the way he's holding his arm up.
A light on Tabs' face. That would be very interesting. Tabs is doing a little bit better right now. He had a very unfortunate time.
Put him in the dark.
With a spider bite the other
Nocturne's
day.
Nocturne's made an appearance.
Yeah, it's getting better.
Hmm.
We'll get that resolved nice quickly.
We'll get that resolved. It's easy enough. There's a lot of lights, ladies and gentlemen, in this studio. We have them all over us. You know, normally I look very tan, but right now I'm looking very pale.
Are you sure?
I am, yeah. Okay. I'm quite sure. I'm quite sure. Thanks, the makeup.
I can't keep track of your skin tone.
Does it change every day? It's called
makeup. A little
bit. It's called makeup. It happens, guys. We have to have it on. Otherwise, we'll just listen at you and shine. But right now, it's Lemondogs that seem to be shining in this game. We're back into the match, ladies and gents, and you can see the red buff has gone across to Dexter, so Lemondogs once again do take a little bit of a lead in this game. You can see gold-wise, they're about 1,000 ahead. Nukeduck goes a little bit aggressive on towards Reginald, Urchin Strike in there, and then just playful tricks us away.
Yeah, it does seem like Dexter was a little bit scared off after he took a red buff for himself. Odd one getting a little bit counter-jungled now. The first pick, Elise, working out fairly well for Lemondogs right here because they seem to have kind of gotten the rest of the picks that they wanted after that anyway.
So pressure on TSM right now. That bottom lane is continuing to be pushed up. We've seen this actually, and how do you stand on this one? Because there's been a right and a wrong stage, and you know, I've heard Doublelift talking about, I've heard Crepo talking about like the bottom lane. It's like shoving it versus holding it.
Oh, I feel like shoving is almost always the right choice if you think you're safe to ganks. It's always a push-pull with how much you gain from having the lane shoved. So the things you gain having the lane shoved is, A, obviously, turret damage. But the bigger thing is versatility, because if there's ever a fight that breaks out in Lemon Dogs' jungle, they'll beat TSM to the spot. Even if there's a fight in TSM's jungle, TSM would then have to choose between the creep wave that is shoved to their turret or actually helping someone. So if you're the team shoving, you always have the freedom to go somewhere else, but you have that inherent danger of someone like the Odd One coming straight through the lane and trying to kill you. But since Tabs and Mythi are such long range on AD carrying support, it's one of the big reasons this lane is so vastly popular, is because it's mainly safe to brute force ganks through the lane. And they also just, since they're pushed up so far, don't really need wards behind them. That's why they only have that plant, actually, because their ward is expired right off on the left side on the river there. And then as long as the mid lane wards the other jungle exit of TSM's jungle, they're effectively safe with just the two wards. They don't have to worry about warding brushes or anything as long as they stay pushed up like that.
And this is actually, you know, talking about the team compositions, this is a team composition that Lemon Dogs have actually played a number of times in Europe. TSM themselves, they've played a fairly similar composition to this a number of times in North America as well. So both on comfortable compositions, but it seems that Reginald's going to crest on. Earth pops up there. Nukeduck's not going to manage to get this one down. Has to use that Spirit Rush Reginald to back away.
Nukeduck's doing a good job in that lane against Reginald as well. He's only 9 minion kills down on Reginald Zarya, gets the Spirit Rush out of him, and is also forcing him back to base, so that actually allows him to catch up nearly even, and Ahri should be winning that matchup early on in the game if he wants to have that chance later on, and because that gank of the mid happened as well, it means Yadon has to hold mid, and it means Dexter gets a free chance to gank Dyrus.
He just simply comes in, puts free damage on Dyrus. Dyrus is just stood around that tower, using that range that Dexter has, going to be the wave shoving in there in a moment, and he's just thinking, have I got my chance to back away?
We missed it on the camera there, but the equalizer cleared the wave, and that's effectively what saved Dyrus's life. While he was toying and trying to dodge Dexter's Elise spells, he cleared the whole wave and prevented the Renekton dive.
So, working out well for him, but he has fell 20 CS behind the lane against Zara Zero. Once again, back in his mid lane, we are seeing Nukeduck coming in. He's just picked up a Sheen, so he's going to be looking maybe to go a bit aggressive on Reginald. He saw that Dexter was waiting in the wings. Reginald has different ideas, looking to try and make a play down the bottom, but it's all warded out.
Walking right through a ward here, so Tabs and Mythi staying safe while pushing up. Nukeduck going in!
Manages to dodge it with the Playful Trickster on the charm. Forces Reginald to flash away. They may continue to pursue this one down the bottom. We do see X Special coming up to help out.
Looks like Reggie's just going to have to back away again. And that's the second time he's kind of been caught off guard by Nukeduck. At this point, Lemon Dogs may just start taking their slow but overwhelming advantage onto TSM. This is the type of game that Lemon Dogs has wanted to play in the World Championship and has generally been blocked away from playing this, because other teams have found holes and gotten kills, like maybe this one in the bottom lane.
Crescendo, True Shot Barrage, and Arcane Shift finishes it off. Wild Turtle goes big on Mythi. And that's the danger of those supports when you're so weak on those hit points. If you can land a good combo, which they seem to be willing to do, it will pay off.
Yeah, the True Shot Barrage did full damage there to Mythi, and that spell hits like a truck if it doesn't have to suffer any pass-through. It's, for some reason, 350 plus 49 plus 23, so it's about 400 plus damage ultimate right at rank 1 there. Wild Turtle shredding through Mythi, and this may very well give TSM a jump on the dragon. Looks like Lemon Dogs is trying to collapse in and put some big harassment down, though.
Putting a lot of pressure on that Odd One, and he was tanking the dragon at the same time, so good work there from Tabs, and that's going to force them away from this one. That's going to hold off the dragon for now.
Yeah, and I think the other thing that stopped TSM from backing off or from staying there was the fact that Zoro Zero had roamed down from mid lane. Since they were able to get that first blood on Dyrus, Zoro Zero has stayed ahead in that lane and went very tanky on Renekton, opting no boots so far in the game, just resist and health. About as powerful as he can be right now with just Colton Bones.
This is a four-man push from Lemon Dogs. We've seen SK Telecom running his exact same type of style. I think Ozone tried to earlier on as well. Just switching around, not really creating the pressure. Bam, four people in the mid, try and take down that turret. But Lemon Dogs not really committing to it this time around.
Yeah, these are the rotations from Lemon Dogs trying to make something happen. Since they were able to take down that lane 2v2 in the bottom, they're trying to kind of just add on to their increasing advantage right now. But because TSM was in position, it ends up backing them away. The longer Lemon Dogs stays in mid lane without getting anything done, the more wasteful that becomes and the less it matters that they're able to take down that first TSM turret.
Zoro Zero immediately going aggressive on Dyrus, but realizing, wait a minute, he's overheating. That flame spitter kind of hurts and had to back away. Zoran Zero doesn't want to take those tower hits either. He has got a big minion lead over Dyrus, but Dyrus now coming back into that lane. He's prepared to defend it and will do. That ultimate of his will hurt, but it is down for the moment. He just gets those ward control down. And Lemon Dogs, again, trying to position for something here.
Yeah, they shoved the bottom lane so quickly and then spent the time to run back mid lane as well. I think one of two things can happen here for Lemon Dogs. They can either catch TSM in a bad rotation while Wild Turtle is shoving the bottom lane, and in that case, Lemon Dogs would get the mid turret, or they can hope to catch probably a shark onto Reginald, get a kill, and then go for a dragon. I think those are the two options Lemon Dogs is going for. And since Lemon Dogs has kind of won all the lanes, or at least had control over most of them, TSM is forced into a very reactive state of play.
Well, Nukeduk hasn't gone back to buy for a while. He's just picked himself up a blue buff. Looks like he may go towards that top lane. Looks like the focus is going to try and get on towards Dyrus. He's going to Urgent Strike, slide across, play for Trickster in there. And he has going to have a clear run on towards Dyrus here. We'll see when this works out for him, though.
It's very difficult to dive Dyrus sometimes, but that might be a shark land. He's got Flash Up.
Equalizer is just available. You can see he uses it, but it's not going to catch on to either Lemon Dogs. The shark misses as well. Zoro Zero taking a lot of damage, but that Dominus should be enough to survive. And Nuko picks up the kill.
Especially with Zoro Zero having rank 2 in Dominus. He is just a behemoth for that turret to try and take down. Dyrus played that pretty much as well as he could, as far as being caught under a turret by a Fizz and a level 11 Renekton, but the brute force of that gank from Lemon Dogs was just enough to take Dyrus down.
But it was enough for TSM to go in and take that dragon down, and now going to put some pressure on towards this mid lane turret. So all square, I guess, in terms of objectives.
Yeah, it's actually Lemon Dogs getting caught in a bad rotation because Tabs is on that wave of shoving, and it's Wild Turtle near the mid lane. TSM going in!
Flash Crescendo, they're going, it's Mithy, they want to get down, they get him! Stranglethorns will pop the odd one up, a lot of tower hits on towards Xspecial. Nobody's going to collapse on towards him, though, and Reginald keeping the pressure down. They don't get the tower, but they did get a kill.
Yeah, I gotta say, game on. Lemon Dogs did take down two turrets, but the mid turret is the most important one, and that's the one TSM has almost conquered right now. And since TSM picked up the dragon, the objective differential isn't that bad for them at this moment. Lemon Dogs, however, knows the TSM dove as they were respawning or running back to mid lane, and they're getting a push of their own.
That's going to be the mid lane turret going down. Nukeduk now picked up the Lich Bane, which is a big power spike over Reginald so far. Yet to go back and get the Deathfire Grasp. We may coming out now. AD carries. You can see Trinity Force from Wild Turtle expected that one. And Bloodthirster actually from Tabs. He's going to go for that, what's he calling it, the Legolas build.
Legolas build is what Krepo calls it. I call it the spell build, but I think Legolas is probably a cooler name, personally. Tabs actually only goes for 4% lifesteal on his rune page. He likes that little extra bit of armor penetration. It's his trademark for those builds.
Well, Reginald wasn't able to complete that Deathfire Grasp. We do see Nukeduk potentially going to come around the side here. Wild Turtle and Xspecial in trouble. They're going to have to back out from this one instead. Choosing not to go for it. He's hanging a long way back. The odd one's going to spot him. There goes the warning signs. Uh-oh. He dives across. Xspecial's going to be the target. They want to pick up a nice, easy kill on one of those supports. He's going to get locked up. It's Dexter that picks up the kill. I think they've made sure he fed that one towards him.
Well, Dexter there picks up 2-0. Another missed shark, though, for Nukeduk. Got to get a little better aim with those things. It's an incredibly tough spell to land, but he was trying to point blanket onto Xspecial as he flashed away. Wasn't quite able to get it in at the right spot. And the Lich Bane had been completed for Nukeduk before that. A lot of the analysts joke that Fizz's build is done as soon as he finishes the Lich Bane. It's just kind of happened from there. I'm actually not entirely sold. I feel like he needs either a Zhonya's or a bit of extra ability power before that really kicks in. Nukeduk caught farming on the side lane. Reginald trying to roam to mid.
Reginald looking around there. He's actually caught between there. Wasn't sure where he was going to go. He was going to try and get around to the back of Mithy. Maybe pick himself up a free kill on that support. Instead, it wasn't to be, and he does back off. We also see Nukeduk. He's backed away. Got himself another amp tome just to get that little bit of extra ability power on there. How do we match up these two AD carries? First round obviously went to Wild Turtle. He was in dominant form in the first game, if you can remember that one. Tams, meanwhile, has started to settle down in this tournament, but unfortunately, it's just a little too late.
Well, Tabs is definitely very comfortable on Caitlyn right now, especially because he's going with his trademark Bloodthirster to Last Whisper build. But at the same time, I respect that Wild Turtle is stronger at this moment in the game with that Trinity Force. I feel like Trinity Force, if you're an AD carry who builds it, you are at your strongest comparable moment in the game the instant you complete it, because it has such efficient stat growth, but not necessarily great multipliers with the rest of your attack damage itemization. So right now, if Wild Turtle can force fights or the rest of TSM can, despite their 2,000 gold disadvantage, they might actually have the upper hand.
Looks like Zorazira's potential target. He walked past that Tribrush Ward, and you could see everybody flinching towards him from TSM. Now they're going to start collapsing. They do see the Tribrush Ward, though, of their own, which will force him to back away into that lane. While this is all happening, it's giving Nuke Duck a lot of time in that bottom lane.
Yeah, this is one of the ways that Nuke Duck always has so much farm on Assassins, even when it seems like he doesn't have any business getting it, is because Lemon Dogs, like most European teams, I think Fnatic is probably the best at it, loves to just hide in brushes while they're pushing up lanes and wait for the other team to unsuspectedly roam towards them. Is Reggie being unsuspecting right now? Is there going to be a shark that comes out here in about 2 seconds?
No.
All right. That's anticlimactic.
Very anticlimactic, it seems. TSM do clear out the wave with that True Shot Brav as well. Just off the side, though, Dexter's taking away the wolves from the Odd One. So countering the counter jungler instead. They're going to jump on Tabs. You can see the Equalizer landing across. Has to force the flash out. Tabs with the barrier as well. They could focus on towards him. TSM may have caught Lemon Dogs out of position. Nuke Duck just takes the blue way. Zorazira has to slice and dice in towards the pit. And they will escape. This may give TSM a rush in the mid.
It's very interesting right now because Tabs has burned barrier and flash and doesn't have anything to lifesteal off of with this Bloodthirster. But at the same time, they know there's no Cataclysm or Equalizer for TSM. So if Lemon Dogs can catch the right fight from behind TSM, we could see a bloodbath.
Reggie going aggressive around the side. Ace in the hole is going to be used to fire off there instead. He does get out of vision range, and Lemon Dogs managed to get around and defend that middle turret. A couple of wards being placed by TSM there. That's going to be great for gold for Lemon Dogs. But they got that mid turret. It's now, that's the first turret of the game, by the way, for TSM. 3-1 in turrets.
I was kind of hoping that they would fight there. But they've got the smart turret. Both teams were down some pretty key things, and it was a high-risk fight. Lemon Dogs as a team is an extremely low-risk team, the most low-risk of every European team. It's definitely been to their detriment thus far at the World Championships, whereas TSM at this point I feel like is hesitant more than anything else, is because philosophically TSM has been actually better in a lot of these games than even the Korean teams, but execution-wise they've made a lot of mistakes, which is actually, I think, just making TSM substantially more cautious with the way they make moves.
Yeah, certainly it seems to be that way. Dyrus, you can see it, 0-2-0 behind on farm towards Zorazira. They have been up against each other pretty much most of this game. Nuke Duck, again, like you mentioned, just like Peke does, laying in wait in that jungle, hoping that he'll catch an unsuspecting special roaming pass just to try and get one of those ward placements in there. Instead, not going to happen, and TSM, once again, 5-man in that mid.
And Dragon fighting against a Rumble that's level 12 is very dangerous. But at the same time, Zorozero's level 14 Renekton, and that's his strongest point in the game as well. So much could teeter on this next fight, only because it seems like Lemon Dogs is quite far ahead, but based on the way they're playing, they're giving TSM a lot of respect because they understand the power of Rumble and the power of Wild Turtle's mid-game Trinity Force.
Well, he has got that Spectral Cowl already, Zorazira, so he's certainly going to be the one that's going in. Dyrus caught out with a cocoon there. Not a great deal of damage, really being completely locked up in that bush.
Both teams are waiting for the other team to commit so that the assassin can go in for their intended target. Nuke Duck was around the back, and at this point, Dexter may finally be committing. Equalizer goes down. He's going to draw a line there, and they're not going to cross it.
Yeah, that's TSM putting that line in the sand, and Lemon Dog's thinking, fine. That is Equalizer down. We're going to have that dragon. And TSM realizing it's like, we can't fight for this anymore. They've already backed off.
Yeah, Lemon Dogs could have rotated mid there. They actually baited TSM because TSM was already moving to defend their middle inner turret. And it just ends up giving Lemon Dogs a quick dragon. That was a little bait and switch right there by Lemon Dogs.
True Shot Barrage did come in. Dexter does smite out that dragon. So, first dragon of the game for the Lemon Dogs. And that's going to make the gold 3,000 in their favor or thereabouts as it just ticks on that way. Still no wards really out on the top half of the map. A lot of wards around that dragon area, so not a great deal of vision for Nuke Duck, who heads towards the top wave to clear it out.
Yeah, Nuke Duck is probably sitting on a bunch of gold, exactly 2,000 gold right now. He's going to want to maybe farm up a bit more so he can buy Zhonya straight up and then really have a large impact on this game. He's actually the top gold earner amongst everyone. 7,500 gold already on Fizz, and I personally feel like Fizz, while he's an assassin, is also a hyper carry. If you combine his total AP ratio, it's over 3, meaning he'll get 3 damage if you run his full spell rotation per ability power, which is incredibly high for most assassins, as well as just being so mobile and generally low late game cooldowns as well. He's quite the force in the late game, and so many of these European mid laners and now world-class mid laners from everywhere have learned how to get to that point with Fizz, which is, I think, one of the big reasons we're seeing his competitive resurgence.
Yeah, you do tend to see them as we found out earlier with Beckett, just popping people where they stand, even when it's against one of your European counterparts in Alex Itch. As it stands, Lemon Dogs are so far looking strong. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We're only at the 24-minute mark. TSM have been to this stage with SK Telecom T1. That was the key deciding turn. But as of yet, neither team have really been looking for that 5v5 fight.
Yeah, SK Telecom definitely puts more pressure on TSM to force decisions. Because TSM in that game against SKT was constantly fighting off their back foot and barely winning a couple fights with Thyrus pressing his Requiem on top lane Karthus and just picking up a kill here and there. Whereas Lemon Dogs is kind of just prancing around and looking for opportunistic fights instead of forcing TSM into really difficult decisions. Maybe now that they have a bit more confidence in an Oracles onto Mythi, they might start denying more vision on TSM. You can already see a bunch of wards in TSM's jungle that Lemon Dogs has placed down. A pink in TSM's blue buff as well. And maybe this is Lemon Dogs forcing TSM more so onto their back foot.
Nuke Duck goes back, buys himself his first tier 1 boots, and he gets himself a Zonic Terrorgrass, as you mentioned.
Boom.
So now he's going to be incredibly strong and very hard to hit. Playful tricks to hands on his Zonic. Going to be keeping him fairly immune. Look at Lemon Dogs. They're 5 manning in towards this mid lane. We do see Zorazoo just keeping his eye on this bottom lane, but it's Lemon Dogs shoving back up. TSM reacting to that. They've secured their blue buff, and now they need to defend that turret.
And this was just Lemon Dogs' playstyle here. Even though they went for the pink ward in TSM's blue buff, they didn't defend the pink ward in TSM's blue buff because they're still respecting Dyrus's equalizer. Even though Dyrus has fallen twice in this game, he's still respectable on Rumble right now. And instead, Lemon Dogs is just avoiding conflict, running all the way up to the top of the map and just chipping away at turrets ever so slowly.
You see Dexter Cataclysm on towards Tabs, but he backs away from it. Equalizer gets used out. Tree Chop Barrage comes across from Wild Turtle. Doesn't find his target. Tabs taken very low. Crescendo not really finding his mark. Mythi's going to go down unless he's got Flash available, which he just about has. Zorazira going very deep alongside Nuke Duck. Nuke Duck does get a special down. Zorazira tanking up that turret. He's got so much hit points as well. Reginald now is going to be the focus target. You see Nuke Duck, that glistening Lich Bane, ready and waiting to go. Ooh. Good to see the Piltover Peacemaker not finding his target. Zorazero will get the stun, the lockdown onto Reggie. Gets that charm on Zorazero. Has he got enough to get away? He hasn't got enough hit points to burn him down. While this is all happening, we do see Nuke Duck chasing on towards Wild Turtle, checking him down, but it's going to be Reggie still continuing to try and take down. But Zorazero will pick up the kill back in the top. The turret goes down, and Lemon Dogs take everything away from TSM.
The whole time Reginald was getting ran down, X Special was respawning at the base. That was a clean set of low-risk takes by the Lemon Dogs. They set up a safe siege on one of TSM's outer turrets, and TSM tried to force and engage through Lemon Dogs, but typical to their style, they reactively responded to TSM. Oh, and got a couple kills.
They got themselves an exit frag. TSM, with that singular ward in that river, managing to get themselves a kill. And the turret in the top, but it's going to be to the detriment of X-Special. Nuke Duck picked himself up an easy kill.
X-Special is not even phased at this point as a support. It's just the worst environment right now for support players on the world stage. So many mid lane assassins are just picking on supports. Nuke Duck surprised him entirely with that, because by all means, he should have went back to base. He was at 1/3 health in the enemy jungle. X-Special thought he had safe ward clearing, but he did not.
Zorazira is so strong in that top lane. He was happy to go in there with his turret and just 3-man defend it. No problem. 3v1, I got this. I can clear this wave, and you're not going to do anything about it, because he's just a big tank right now. Level 16, highest on the map as well, causing all sorts of problems for TSM.
Yeah, it's looking a little bit grim for TSM right here, only because Wild Turtle's Trinity Force build, while he's farming very well, doesn't necessarily scale at the level of what Tabs is going to be building. Tabs actually opted out of the Bloodthirst Last Whisper build, and Reginald gets a little bit caught. Can they get him? Nope.
Well, X-Special standing by with that Crescendo. It's not up yet, actually. It's up in a second if it was required, but instead.
So Nuke Duck boots mobility home guard as well. Instead of Magic Pen boots on Fizz, that definitely tells me not much, actually. It tells me he's looking to split push as much as possible. Because it's weird. I build home guard boots when I'm behind. Nuke Duck builds it when he's ahead.
Shark, it's going to be another free kill. It's Exp Special going down, and Nuke Duck continues to pad those stats. The Odd One caught out. Cataclysm is out of it. That's a very good equalizer, actually. Killing it all across Nuke Duck. You can see the damage doing a lot on towards him. Wild Turtle trying to get in there. The pressure on towards Zoro is zero. Not really the focus target he should be going for. He's happy to tank up all that damage. Grasping Roots comes in. Arcane shifted out of by Wild Turtle. Fairly even exchange, but it was two deaths for TSM.
Zoro Zero is playing a tank like an absolute beast right now. He is soaking up so much damage from TSM, and it's allowing Lemon Dogs to really have a solid two-threat team like they usually do. Nuke Duck on his Hypercarry Assassin and Tabs on his reliable mid lane AD. That's the way Lemon Dogs plays. You can even see it with Dexter's build. He does this all the time on Elise. It's Spirit of the Ancient Golem, Lock of the Island Solari. He doesn't even have magic penetration thus far on Elise because he is there as a peel tank for the two main threats of Lemon Dogs.
Zoro Zero is about to get that Randian's Omen, I believe, in as well. So we'll see. It's just going to be the full front line. There's not a lot they can do against him. They just got to ignore him in there and try and get past him. But the problem is they can't get past that front line because Nuke Duck's just assassinating the back.
Yeah, and at this point, Zoro Zero is almost just trying to body block Wild Turtle's Mystic Shots. Without a Last Whisper being completed onto Wild Turtle, he's not able to touch Zoro Zero. And if Zoro Zero is always in the way, he's not able to get a Tabs either, and that's going to give Tabs a lot of freedom to kill the Odd One, who is effectively trying to be the only true tank for TSM, and it will leave the rest of TSM squishies effectively vulnerable to anyone on Lemon Dog's tank or dive line.
So we do see Lemon Dogs grouping up in this jungle area. And remember, Dyrus does have his ulti back. It's a pretty quick ulti. He's already up. Oracle in there. Ward gets cleared. We do see Reggie's going to pick up his own blue buff as well. So the lanes are all being pushed, so bottom, top, and the middle, all being shoved in by Lemon Dogs. Lemon Dogs seem to be rotating and focusing a little bit more towards his top half of the map, which is why Dyrus has got to be careful because there is a shark waiting in the brush.
Nuke Duck hasn't caught many sharks this game, aside from the ones on X Special. I feel like he's the majority.
It's the slowest target on the map. It's an easy one.
Yeah, squishiest target.
Yep.
All the assassins always pick on him. Really is a difficult life for support so far in the World Championship. And Lemon Dogs is in a very large amount of control right here. You can see Nuke Duck taking advantage of his home guard boots mobility, trying to fly out to counter push that Reginald lane. While the rest of Lemon Dogs is really just maintaining a presence in the mid lane here, they're definitely setting up for a potential Baron ploy right now, because you can see Lemon Dogs has five wards in the TSM jungle, very far beyond the Baron. And this at least looks like the smart approach to a Baron, because they're only looking for TSM to basically force a face check at this point. They want to catch a fight of Lemon Dogs. Anytime X Special goes with an Oracles into one of these brushes, he is risking catching a fish.
Just like that, Dyrus chunked down, half his hit points goes down, and that was only the support and top laner, I believe it was, doing the damage there. You can see Dexter in there, Zoro Zero is going to go in. There he is, that front blocking damage, and now Nuke Duck joins the party. The fish gets thrown out. X Special will be the focus on the sidelines, but Wild Turtle's in all sorts of trouble. Reginald taken very low. That's a really good ultimate from Dyrus. Is it going to be enough to slow him down? No, it will not. Wild Turtle just at the back. Zoro Zero will finally go down, but it's going to be Reginald that follows. Mithy gets in there. The Odd One gets locked up. He gets taken down as well. And it was another 3-for-1 for the Lemon Dogs.
And Tabs, or Nuke Duck, arrived right at the end there on Fizz, able to heavily dive in. He actually did pick up Reginald with an extended Ignite kill, and now it could just be a Baron take by Lemon Dogs. There is only two up on TSM that would try to stop this, and Lemon Dogs can take the Baron fairly quickly despite them being low. Surprisingly, though, that ward is still giving TSM a bit of vision, and Dyrus, nah, he can't get that.
He hasn't got Equalizer available. Nuke Duck's got to be careful tanking it up. That it will be the Baron. Zoro Zero did not get it. They couldn't have the time to wait for him to respawn, and Nuke Duck's going to continue on actually farming. He's going to have a lot of gold right now because he's been farming waves before that. Again, 2,300 gold on him. Tabs, 2,700 gold. Big stacks.
Yep, those mobility boots for Nuke Duck have allowed him the ability to push up side lanes and then still participate in team fights. Nuke Duck had been underperforming a little bit so far from an endgame scoreline, but that's generally because Lemon Dogs relies on him to do so much. Dyrus has got those senses right now.
He's just going to keep that lane pushing. And as he's there, misses the harpoon. But I want to draw your attention to Tabs' build. While this actually gank is not going to happen, I think Dyrus should be able to get away from this one. No, he won't. There's going to be a nerve popping out. He's going to get locked up there. The equalizer comes out, but look at the burst damage coming out from Nukeduck. Zoro Zero comes around. They step around the equalizer. Urchin Strike comes in. Nukeduck picks another one up.
6-0-2 on Fizzent. Uh-oh. Dexter
going down to the jungler. Damage? That's not what you need.
Tabs also had Ace in the Hole on Reginald there, which completely swung the tides. Haunting Guys actually picked up on Dexter before Sorcerer's Shoes, so always picking up a little bit of health whenever he picks up his offensive itemization. Gives Lemon Dogs even more control in this one.
Tabs was what I wanted to talk about because he hasn't gone Legolas. He's gone for that Phantom Dancer straight afterwards, that Spectral Cowl. Now he's just picked up the extra BF sword as well. And he's putting a ton of damage on these turrets.
At this point, he doesn't care much about the armor penetration because TSM doesn't have armor. Odd One, the only armor he has is the little bit he gets from his Aegis of the Legion. And now has recently completed Ninja Tabi, but the rest of Nukeduck is diving through so heavily that at this point, Tab's just looking for the straight up AD. Ouch!
Fire Grasp doing some damage there. Nukeduck's picked that one up, and you just saw Wild Turtle. If that Earth would have landed, it'd have been dead.
Yeah, that's the hyper carry Nukeduck coming through right now. Lemon Dogs, with Tabs and Nukeduck being their two main offensive threats, are doing quite well because they have TSM effectively contained to their base right now. Nukeduck has been doing so much roaming around and running with his home guard, boots of mobility. Once again, zippity-doo-da-day and down to that giant creep wave in the bottom lane. It's going to pop him over 300 for the game. And this dragon could be another big fight.
They're going in for Dexter. He repels away. We do see a very good Cataclysm coming out along with the True Shot Barrage. Dexter will go down. Mithy will follow. It's two kills for Dyrus there. Now Zorazira is going to be the focus target. Are Lemon Dogs feeling cocky here? Ace in the Hole finds the Odd One.
It's strange. Lemon Dogs has a lot of power up right now. The three strongest people are able to fight this one if they can get some type of engage.
The charm lands on towards Zoro Zero. TSM try to turn it. I'm not too sure they realize. Nukeduck's coming around. It's Wild Turtle. They catch on. Flashes in towards the pit. Zoro Zero follows him straight in there. Equalizer comes in. Reginald just gets melted where he stands. And it's going to be Zoro Zero that gets the kill. Tabs doing work on Dyrus. X Special, the next focus. You do see the crescendo, but it's too little, too late. 90 caliber net. Sonya's Hourglass baited in there. Urchin Strike through. It's a 7-0-4 for Nukeduck.
Wild Turtle mistiming his Mystic Shot. Post Sonya's onto Nukeduck, getting outplayed by the moves from Nukeduck's Fizz right there. It's 1.5 seconds that Sonya's Hourglass is under there, and it got miscounted. So here, it's that 3v4 we talked about. Nukeduck blowing up Reginald because Deathfire Grasp was before all of his magic damage. At that point, Zoro Zero, the tankiest of tanks at this point. Supports have a hard life. And then specifically the Zhonya's timing, after getting Wild Turtle to turn and send off an entire auto attack, really secured that kill for Tabs and Nukeduck.
Destructive forces of Lemon Dogs. TSM managed to get first blood in this game, but it seems that Lemon Dogs are looking strong.
Dyrus.
What I mean is the first game. 1-0.
Oh, in the matchup.
Give me a chance to finish there, Jan. We'll get there in the end. Well,
it's kind of a take and turn.
First blood, taking a kill. I want to see a third game now between these. I want to see who's going to go in a best of three. But at the moment, Reginald takes that ace in the hole and is forced to back away. Oh, it's going to be a flash. Dyrus is going to get caught. It's Reginald they wanted to get on. They've actually caught up Nukeduck very nicely. Zhonya's Hourglass not available. And that is going to shut him down. Wild Turtle gets the kill. Tabs now have to use the barrier to get away. Charm does not land. The rest of Lemon Dogs are closing back in, but they have to back away from this one. TSM are going to be chasing the kills. Cataclysm locking up Zoro Zero and Dexter. Tabs comes around though. He's getting free hits to the back. Can he turn the damage around? Challenges to get a 90 caliber net on Dyrus, and they lock him up. They should be backing away from this one. Both teams very low.
Yeah, Lemon Dogs with only two main damage threats. If Nukeduck goes down, they don't got much left.
All about the base. You can see the super minions getting in there. TSM having to deal with this one. Lemon Dogs are just going to rotate around, keep those lanes shoved.
And TSM is completely constrained to their base as well. 6 turrets to 2. The gold lead has extended to 11,000. While the shutdown was beneficial in keeping TSM alive and in this game, it also makes sure Wild Turtle has a bit more time to scale up. Now having that last whisper, it's going to do wonders and maybe hurting Zoro Zero at least a little bit as he tries to block all the Mystic Shots, but Nukeduck's up now, zipping back, trying to push up some lanes, and TSM basically is trying extremely hard to force fights before Fizz gets back into business.
Yeah, we're talking about sprinting to that top lane, realized he needs to come around. The rest of his team thinking they may get focused on with TSM, but instead, It's all free damage. So let's take stock of the situation, Jap, because it's been a little while, but one of these guys before we had a chance to check the items, because it's been a lot of action going on.
Yeah, there's really been a lot of fighting in this game. It started very slow, but it has accelerated greatly since then. And it's been all about Nuke Duck at this point. Knowing that Tabs has also completed his Infinity Edge means that the two threats are very real threats right now for Lemon Dogs. The control is still apparent in TSM's jungle. It means TSM can't look out towards the Baron. Lemon Dogs has already picked up one Baron so far this game. They're going to be looking for number two. And it's a very Lemon Dog style game as far as the overall late game has been going.
Yeah, Nuke Duck running off the stage there, so we'll see what's up with that at the moment. They have a big advantage in this game, though. Let's talk about 18-7 in kills, 59,000 to 48, so it's a 10,000 gold advantage so far. Lemon Dog's in control.
Yeah, right there, obviously, as you mentioned, Zoro ran right off the stage. Hope he's going to be all right for that one. He's having a pretty good game.
Actually. He's having a very good game,
to be fair. Considering he had to go
right
off the stage.
He's, 219 at the moment.
Yeah,
and
he's so tanky.
A movable tank. I think he's got about 4,000 hit points.
Yeah, let's check that, actually. Right now, 0-0 is, 3,966.
Pretty good
guess. Intuition is fantastic. And more importantly, 216 armor to block those mystic shots that Wild Turtle's been trying to hit him with.
It's all about that awesome patch where the little markers stand in there.
You counted 40.
Pretty good for us. We can see the four knocks in there, but... We just went in to sort things out. Of course, the pause is on right now. This is the first game of Group A, and there's another couple of games to go. OMG coming up, and SK Telecom will be facing off the final game of the day as well. And after that, the quarterfinal draws.
That quarterfinal draw that we're going to have at the end of the day is going to be so key, because we already know the four teams that are moving on so far from the group stage. Two teams from Europe, Fnatic and Gambit, SK Telecom, T1. And OMG, who is currently undefeated, will have to see if they can stay undefeated and be the only undefeated team in the group stage. And they're going to be drawing for their chance to play Cloud9, number one seed in North America, Royal, number one seed in China, Gamma Bears, number one team from the Southeast Asia region, and just trying to list all these off. There's got to be one more. It is obviously Najin Black Sword, who is the number one seed from Korea, but not necessarily thought of as the strongest Korean team coming in.
Which is interesting, because we don't know a great deal about them. Najin Sword, they didn't qualify for the summer season of the champions. However, they have flown in Najin Shield, the Najin White Shield, their sister team, to practice. So effectively practicing in the darkness.
Yeah, and that could be the surprising thing. A lot of those players are also making a return appearance here to the World Championships, because aside from Mac Noon, four of those returning players are going to be back here at the World Championships. And they've been... You're absolutely right. They've been dark, essentially, in Korea. They've been playing in the NLB, which is essentially the sub-league there over in Korea, and picked up the last few of their circuit points by winning that league. And from some of the games I watched, they hadn't been looking that strong, but word on the street is that they've been improving greatly. So we'll really just have to wait and see once those matchups come down.
Yeah, there's definitely the two surprise packages is Sword and Gamma Bears. Gamma Bears, we watched the TPS matches. They look pretty good.
Yeah, Gamma Bears, though, does play slow. Yeah. And we have yet to see a slow team actually succeed here at the World Championships. Lemon Dogs is a bit of a slow team. When TSM methodically dominated Season 2, they were the fastest of the slow North American teams, but they are nothing compared to how fast some of these Chinese and Korean teams have been playing.
And speaking of that slow play, it blends perfectly into exactly what we're seeing from the Lemon Dogs in this match, because you can see it's coming up to the 40-minute mark. They have a big control. They have that 10,000 lead, 6-2 turrets, inhibitor down, yet they're not going for the jugular. They're taking their time because they realize actually there's still a lot of big danger from TSM.
And they do know that they have a hyper carry in Nuke Duck, who is very close to finishing his Rabadon's death cap. They're actually trying to burst down that Baron before TSM can get into range. TSM's running at it, but a couple people are baiting.
They're
going to
peel out. Stranglethorns gets down. His Wild Turtle is going to get locked up. He's going to go down very, very quickly. Can they focus the next target? Dyra seems to be the one. Zoro getting in amongst the team. Reginald's going to get locked up. He's taken down. We see a Crescendo coming across, locking up four members of Lemon Dogs, but there's no damage left available. We do get one kill. It's Tech Special on the extra support. Zoro gets on towards Dyra. Odd One's going to be the next focus target. We see Nuke Duck trying to slide in there. Urchin Strike will be available any second now. Locks on towards him. Doesn't have the damage. Can he hop in there? Ace in the Hole comes out. Playful Trickster still can't get the Urchin Strike. There it is. manages to lock down the odd one. It is simply going to be X Special left to fend off alone.
And knowing we're 40 minutes in, once the fifth kill comes down for the ace, Lemon Dogs has the middle inhibitor exposed. This could be the ace and the game for Lemon Dogs.
That is going to be the inhibitor going down. It's simply the Baron Peel from the Lemon Dogs. And 40 minutes gone into this game, it will be Lemon Dogs closing it out. TSM will unfortunately go down to them. That's actually going to put them, ironically, equal in the group. It's 1-1 between these two teams.
Yeah, that actually puts Lemon Dogs ahead of them in the group overall standings, I believe, but tied in their head-to-head matchups. It's a bit of revenge there for Lemon Dogs because they absolutely didn't like losing to TSM early on. The NA versus EU rivalry here, number two seeds coming in from both the European and North American scenes. Lemon Dogs ties it up.
And that's got to feel good for Nukeduck because he's not had a great tournament. He's been fairly focused. He came into this tournament, you're seeing there on your screen, fairly well publicized, it feels. You know, the strong, the mid laners in the middle. You got to look, he's up alongside Peke and Alex Hitch, who both have had some fantastic tournaments so far. Finally goes 8-1-6 in this tournament up against Reginald in that mid.
Yeah, Zoro Zero really went back to his core style in this game. He was able to make his own set of decisions and really just look for the Sharks, hide in the right brushes, and then make plays on his own accord. That's not something he was allowed to do in a lot of the other games.
Yeah, big tank. So, Lemon Dogs do take the first game of Group A. Of course, coming up, it's going to be OMG. It's going to be a very strong game for them. We'll see how fast it is going to be. We saw the odd one talking about, we mentioned how quick it was, making me look bad, man. But, you know, they have played really well.
Yeah, we got a few things coming up. I mean, we want to see if Gaming Gear can get their win, see if they can make the big impact that they wanted to, or at least make a stamp on the World Championships. And then we also got to see if OMG can be the undefeated 8-0 team throughout. So there's a few little storylines we got coming up.
Yeah, Peke and crew will be waiting. They've got a 7-1 record. Can OMG beat it? But right now, we are going to get across.